Today, we are going to learn how to create this looping 260 reframe video in the highest image quality possible. This is a 4K video output, but for giggle, here is before cleanup, color grading, speed ramp, and sound effects. As you can see, it makes a huge difference in the final quality. Want to step up your 260 editing skill? This is the tutorial for you. We will cover all the latest updates on the GoPro Max, including the 3K 60 frames per second in the latest firmware, a new features in GoPro Player on macOS and the upcoming Windows release, and a very important update on the GoPro FX Reframe plugin that will impact not even GoPro Max, but 260 reframe image quality on all 260 cameras, including Insta 260 1X and 1R. And here is a timecode for your convenience. We got a lot to cover, so let's go. Hey, what's up everybody, it's your boy Hugh here from Creator Up, number one YouTube channel dedicated to 260 filmmaking for everyone. GoPro Max just has a firmware update that allows you to capture 3K in 60 frames per second. It is like 6 months too late, but it is finally here, and it is pretty amazing. As you know, we do unbiased reviews and apples to apples comparison in Creator Up. So, let's find out how good is the new slow motion compared to other popular 260 cameras. They are all in different sizes and different frame rate, so we normalize it in the same resolution by zoom in 4 times on the video chart, which is the best way to test image quality. Even though Insta 260 1R 3K slow motion is bigger in size compared to GoPro Max, the image quality is not better than Max. I think Max is slightly better than 1R in 3K, but 1R can do 4K in 50 frames per second, not 60, but it is still slow motion if you are in PAL countries. 4K is a lot better than 3K, and if you reframe in 360, I will go with 4K at least. Coolcam 8K is also 4K in slow motion. The image quality is as good as 1R in 4K. Actually, I would say Coolcam 8K has the best image quality amongst all. Let's look at slow motion quality. We slow down 4 times as they are action cameras. For free falling extreme sport like base jumping or skydiving, 4 times slow motion is pretty standard. The result is pretty obvious. 1R 50 frames per second is not good. GoPro Max 60 frames per second is very choppy as well. The 1R 3K is decent, but the Coolcam 8K 120 frames per second is no doubt the winner here. So, if you are looking for a true slow motion 260 camera, then Coolcam 8K is probably the best. Well, I still don't think Coolcam 8K can be considered as an action camera because of the size and the weight, but pure image quality wise, it is the best in slow motion. I would recommend to watch this apple to apple comparison in 360 when you get a chance. In regular speed, it is an entire different story. GoPro Max is actually really good. Go check that video out. Our goal here is to squeeze every pixel resolution out from the GoPro Max. So shooting in less than 4K resolution is not ideal. So personally, I don't use it. But you ask, hey Hugh, your intro video clearly has silky smooth slow motion, speed ramping. How? Well, keep watching. The second thing I want to cover is GoPro Player on Mac and PC. It is the preferred way to get the highest image quality out from your GoPro Max using ProRes or Cineform Render. Please don't ever use a phone unless you don't care about image quality. Every big guy you saw on Instagram are using a desktop, including GoPro themselves. So follow the best practices. We are not going to cover GoPro Player on Windows in this video. It is still in beta and I'm pretty sure I'm not allowed to tell you anything, but I can tell you it is so worth the wait. PC is going to blow Mac users away when this is out. So if you are PC, be patient. GoPro is working day and night to give you the best software. GoPro Player on Mac OS has several important updates, including native motion blur. This feature alone is going to be so much better than using the InStar Zuxi Studio 2020. I cannot find any good and current tutorial on the GoPro Player on YouTube, so I'm going to go over the new feature and workflow for you right now. First, let's talk about the new features, cinematic motion blur. As you see, there's motion blur already in the reframe animation. If you put your playhead in between keyframes, you can open up the easing dialog box. On the right, you see the new motion blur setting. In here, you have full control of the shutter angles, basically how much blur you want. So if you are moving slow, increase the shutter angle will make it blurrier. As you see, we have a real-time playback, which is always great for editing. You can also just increase the motion blur as well to create a very interesting creative look. Next, we have the relevel button right here to level your footage with a click of a button. So much better than the old rotation lock button. You can also use the zoom lock button to zoom easily now. Now we can also resize the output format, like right here we do the 4x5 Instagram post. And here is the render with the new motion blur setting. Everything is very self-explained and easy to use. Even though the GoPro Player has cinematic motion blur now, it is still not a good software to do 360 reframe if you want the best image quality. The new GoPro FX Reframe plugin version 1.2 and above for Adobe Premiere implement the Lenso resampling. This almost doubled the sharpness compared to bicubic resampling, which is everybody else using. It is computational more expensive, but the reframe result is a lot better. And that is why if you can reframe even your InStar Zuxi 1R or 1X with the brand new GoPro FX Reframe plugin. And that is the secret why my reframe video looks so sharp even in 4K. Now let's learn all the tips and tricks on recreating the intro video in Adobe Premiere using the brand new GoPro FX Reframe plugin. Here, I'm going to walk you through my editing. In section 1, I just followed this tutorial on GoPro FX Reframe plugin to reframe the video to my liking. The goal here is to cut out the FPV drone using reframing. It is easy to do in 4x5, but it is impossible in 16x9. I want to keep the tiny planet view as the epic opening establishing shot, so I decided to keep the drone in and remove it later in After Effects. Also, I will remove the FPV shadow as well. If you can see the drone shadow, you know this is captured by drone. It is not as cool. If you remove it, now viewer will have no idea how you capture that crazy camera movement. They might think you have a really long pole and just an amazing action spot cinematographer. Well, in fact, it is not. The camera did all the magic. Pay attention here, it is the same one take max footage, but I chop it up and disable motion blur in the second part. Why? Because I want to trick the viewer into thinking this is a high frame rate camera. High frame rate camera has less motion blur when in fast motion. The fast motion is created in Premiere with keyframes. When you remove motion blur, it looks like the GoPro Max is shooting at 120fps, but in fact, you are shooting at 30 frames per second with smart editing tricks. Pretty neat, huh? But now we need to really slow down the jump as he's falling really fast. Wait, that is a 4x slowdown. And why the speed ramp so smooth? Well, the trick is I actually swap camera here. You just can't tell. The falling part is actually from a GoPro Hero 8, shooting in 120fps in 2K. Two cameras are mounting on the same drone, as you see on my original 2X GoPro Max drone tutorial right here. But instead of another GoPro Max, we use a GoPro Hero 8 on top. If you don't know already, Heroes 8 Black and GoPro Max are perfect together as they have a very similar color matrix. If you want to know how I color grade and match them together, it's with my brand new cinematic LUT pack right here. So go download it for free now. You can reframe GoPro Max to match the movement of the Heroes 8 exactly as we did right here. I put the Heroes 8 on top and dropped the opacity to 50% and matched them together. It does not need to be exactly the same as well. We can use speed ramping to match them together with sound effects. As you see right here, we speed up the GoPro Max, again, without motion blur, and also speed up the Heroes 8 at the beginning just enough to match the motion of the Max. And then immediately we slow down for the drop. Look at the end result. Amazing. This is how I do a speed ramping for GoPro Max or just any 360 cameras. First, I nest the reframe video. This is a very important step. Whenever you are playing with the speed, you always nest your reframe just like in After Effects pre-comp. If not, you will run into issues. Then, right-click on the newly nested sequence, show clip keyframes, time remapping, speed, fry the right time and insert a keyframe. Move this line up to speed up your footage. Drag right here to create a ramp. See this little handlebar right here? Make sure to drag it to the right to create easy ease on your speed ramp. That's it. Very easy. We are going to do the same to the Heroes 8 footage. We slow it down really fast and slowly speed it back up to create drama. A very basic music video editing techniques. As you see, I am not just a normal YouTuber. I am a real professional sharing you my industry secrets so you can learn what the big boys are doing. Please thank me with a big thumb up and share this video. Last thing I want to share with you before we jump into After Effects is sound design. Sound design is so important in anything you do. Let's watch the sequence without sound design. Now watch it with sound design. Crazy, right? It is the attention to details that makes your content go viral. That is how much work I put into my personal production on a simple Instagram post. Are those 5,000 plus views easy to gain? No, it is all hard work. Just like every other Instagrammer, we work hard, very hard for the likes. So if you see something you like on Instagram or TikTok next time, give that creator a like and comment as well. The best way to reward an artist is to show them you actually care. I think now it is a good time to break. I want to save After Effects in the next tutorial. As you see here, removing the drone and the shadow are so important. Sometimes just removing your tripod leg makes a huge difference. And trust me, your followers see your effort and they will appreciate it with a like and thank you comment. Thank you for geeking out with me again in 360. This workflow will give you the best 360 reframe image quality. But if your source is larger than 5.7K, for example, 8K from the CoolCam 8K or Insta360 Pro 2 or 11K from the Titan, and you want cinematic quality, then I would recommend to watch my next tutorial back in DaVinci Resolve on how to get the best resolution for 360 reframe if you have an ultra high resolution source file. This new workflow will solve the low resolution problem my viewers encounter when reframing with DaVinci Resolve. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not already and hit the notification bell to stay ahead of the game in 360 editing. And I will see you in the next tutorial real soon. Thank you.
Thank you.